Please welcome to the 700 Club, Brian Littrell of the Backstreet Boys. Great to have you here.
Thank you for having me.
God bless you. You had a phenomenal success as a member of that group. Why did you decide to do a Christian album, Brian?
Well, actually, I started in Christian music, growing up singing in church as a 4- and 5-year-old. And I had an opportunity to go to Cincinnati Bible College, where I was going to study youth ministry and music ministry on a vocal scholarship. And that's what I thought God had planned for my life.
So I guess instead of asking you why the Christian album, I should say how the Backstreet Boys.
Well, a little bit of both, a little bit of both. I thought God had a plan for me to study youth ministry and music ministry, but that was when he used me in the secular world, in the music business with the Backstreet Boys. And I'm blessed and I'm fortunate and very lucky to have a God-given gift and be able to use it for him.
So. That, I took my daughter a number of years ago when she was young to a Backstreet Boys concert, and it wasn't just the young girls who were jumping and screaming. The moms were right. I was looking around. I thought, I'm surrounded here.
I have to say, the moms are... They're the craziest, I would say.
I would go right along with you on that one. It was a great experience. Tell me about how your faith has played a role in the success that God's given you in the secular world.
Well, I think God has always held me accountable to a standard, a certain standard. Growing up, family and faith and my religion has always been the most important thing in my life, and it's never been compromised. I would have to say, on behalf of the secular world of music business.
Can I tell you how refreshing that is? Because we hear a lot of people in the secular market who come from Christian roots who talk about that. But what you see is over a window of time, the success and the environment changes them. How did you keep that from happening to you?
Well, talking about it and standing for it are two different things. And God's provision in my life has been amazing. Growing up with a heart condition and undergoing heart surgery in 1998 as a 23-year-old young man, God has always had these huge events that have happened in my life that have kept me so close to my family and my faith in Him.
Well, I'm sure that played a role in it. That heart condition was something you dealt with from the time you were very, very young. Did it give you a sense that God's hand had a purpose in your life and that you needed to keep your eyes open to that?
Completely. I think as Christians, we pray for doors to be opened in our lives. And sometimes when they do, we become hesitant in a way. We're like, oh, no, not now, on my time. And we need to step out in faith. And I think through the events in my life, God has had nothing but, I wouldn't say His one hand. I think He's just embraced me my whole life, and He continues to do so even in this solo venture.
And He always, when we give Him those areas of struggle in our lives, He always does something positive and usually for other people with it. You've taken that experience with your heart health and turned it into the Healthy Heart Club for Kids. Tell me about that.
Well, we founded the organization, the Brian Littrell Healthy Heart Club for Kids, in 1999, late 98, early 99. And we wanted to create an environment for kids as well as families to live a heart-healthy lifestyle, eating right. And power, I think, is wisdom. And having the right wisdom and knowing what to put in your body, knowing how to treat your body from the exterior standpoint, is what kids need to know. They watch TV so much, coming in from school playing video games. They need to become active again, because 20 years ago, we didn't have those things.
Yes. Well, we are hearing from you in all of this, but I want to bring your wife, Leanne, in. Leanne, come on. Come on down, as they say.
That's right.
Great to have you with us.
Thank you.
You all live a very interesting lifestyle. You have a son.
Mm-hmm.
In fact, he sings on the CD that you just did, right?
Yes, he does.
With you, so he's obviously gotten the gift. Look at this. Do you love it?
Oh.
With passion, no less.
Absolutely.
That's him at a Backstreet Boys sound check, actually. He likes to run the sound check on the tour last year.
But now, are you still traveling a great deal, Brian? You are, right?
Yes, we are.
Leanne, how do you deal with that?
Well, we go. We just... son is a gold medallion member on Delta.
3 years old.
So we go, and we just make home wherever we are. And we just...
Wow. Was this a whole new experience for you? Had your life included any of this before you met Brian?
I was an actor, so I traveled anyway. And
so you're both sort of used to this whole...
Absolutely. I think, too, I wouldn't know anything different because I traveled as an actor and everything. And so when we met, it was perfect because I understood his schedule. Not the magnitudes, but...
Now, let me just say, I mentioned to Brian, I went to one of the Backstreet Boys concerts a number of years ago. And I can't imagine what I would feel like as a wife if I were in the background watching these women go spastic over my husband.
I love it. Well, when they're not cheering for him, I'm like, why are they cheering for somebody? Don't you think he's the cutest?
Candidate number three.
Right. I pick him. At first, it was a little odd, to think, oh, wow, everybody's crazy. It was like Beatlesque, you know.
Yes.
But to me, I feel like it's a compliment because I know where his heart is and I know where we are, so I don't feel threatened.
You know, I want to say that your husband did such an amazing thing to me that must have so blessed you as his wife. When you were with the Backstreet Boys, they were doing a spread in, what was the magazine?
Rolling Stones.
They wanted the picture to be a compromising one with women who were scantily clad, and you said... You wouldn't do it, first of all, because of your stance as a Christian, but also because you wouldn't disrespect your wife in that way.
Absolutely.
What did that make you feel?
It's so funny because right before I got the phone call, I had felt this just amazing pressure to pray. Like, I just needed to pray. And I was like, I wonder if husband's okay. Because I call him husband. I wonder if husband's okay. And I just prayed. I was... 5 minutes I prayed and he called me and he told me what was going on, and it was really like a huge milestone for him. But I don't know, I'm so proud of him, and he's such a great heart, and that's why
awesome.
I fell in love with him.
It's awesome to see you stand together like this. What's the greatest challenge of life as you know it on the road?
Getting up at 5 a.m.?
No, I'm just kidding. I think the greatest challenge in life for me right now is fatherhood. I think it's the most challenging, but yet the most rewarding.
Huge responsibility, isn't it?
I wouldn't change anything for the world for my little boy. And I want him to have the best life that he can have. I want him to know God. So.
That's awesome. That is awesome. Well, I want to mention that your new release is Welcome Home, and you can find out more about Brian Littrell and his Healthy Heart Club at CBN.com. While you're there, check out his solo album, Welcome Home. And right now, please welcome Brian Littrell as he sings the title song from Welcome Home. Great to have you with us.
Thank you.
Thank you, Brian.
I'm going to head on over
Thanks,
here.
Liam. Yes, please.
But I laid it all down, gave everything in my hair and the words that my father said. You're never far, I will be where you are. And when you come to me, I will open my arms. Welcome home, you, I know you by name. How do you do? I shine because of you today, so come and sit down, tell me how you are. I know, son, it's good just to see your face. When I look at you holding my heart, I will give to you all that I have. Son, I know there'll be times you will feel all alone. I will share with you the words my father said. You're never far, I will be where you are. And when you come to me, you can bet I will open my arms. Welcome home, you, I know you by name. How do you do? I shine because of you today, so come and sit down, tell me how you are. I know, son, it's good just to see your face. See, I've been waiting for that day, just to feel your warm embrace. I shine because of you today. So come and sit down, tell me how you are. I know, son, it's good just to see your face. When I left home to be who I am, some people said, no way.